In many ways, Mumia's fate and the fate of so many political prisoners is bound up in our movements in the streets around Black Lives Matter, around the crisis in Flint, around Palestine. Mumia needs us to connect his case. And his case, if you read it, is outrageous in terms of the police corruption, in terms of the falsification of evidence, in terms of the suppression of the movement by the police. What Mumia needs is for us to connect his case and the case of the 2 million people who were imprisoned with police brutality. Mumia needs love, letters. Mumia needs you to send a letter to the governor. We have petitions right now to the governor demanding hepatitis C treatment for Mumia and the 10,000 other prisoners in Pennsylvania who have hepatitis C. On April 22nd, 23rd, and 24th, the movement is going to convene in Philadelphia for Mumia's birthday. Our demand is freedom, but also hepatitis C treatment. Mumia needs you to convene a meeting, a protest, a gathering right here in this church or in the streets of Oakland that connects his case to the case of other political prisoners. Mumia needs us to demand that Oscar Lopez be freed. President Obama can demand Oscar Lopez's immediate release. That will raise the profile of other political prisoners. I just want to say that Angela Davis has said something about incarceration and imprisonment that has clarified things for me. Incarceration is important because prisons are the most repressive institutions in our society. And when we ask questions of incarceration, we begin to ask questions about the whole nature of our society. And that really raises the issue of abolition. Mumia needs us to begin to ask questions that challenge the very nature of society, but that also imagine the kind of society that we want to live in and that we want to dedicate our lives fighting for.